Rad Radio. Rad Radio.
Me and Ralph had like a chat brainstorm session together, and we were just shooting names back and forth, and at some point I came up with Bass Jackers, and Ralph like didn't say anything for like a few seconds. He's like, yeah, that sounds really cool. So Bass Jackers it is. I think the difference between the Netherlands and other countries in the world is when you grow up in the Netherlands, you grow up with dance music. Like, when I was really young, dance music was already in the mainstream charts. So basically, it's part of your life from a really young age. And I think that it's in our culture. We live and breathe dance music. And I think that's the difference between the Netherlands and the rest of the world. And I think that's why a lot of young kids start producing dance music, started being a DJ at a really young age. And I think that is why we have a little advantage compared to the rest. Basically, you can get your inspiration anywhere, but I think we just we listen to a lot of music. It's not specifically dance music, but of course you get a lot of inspiration from other artists and producers that you appreciate. And I think we get a lot of inspiration from the shows. I mean, like, I'm the one that's DJing, but Ralph is the one that's producing. But whenever I'm back in the studio, I give that DJ feedback, you know, like I give that DJ input, and what I see at the shows, like how I see the crowd respond on certain sounds or certain beats, it's what I bring back to Ralph when we go in the studio together. And that's how a new track comes about. Like, Ralph's gonna make like a new sketch for a track. I'm gonna come in the studio and bring my ideas, and the end result is what a Bass Jackers track is. So Wave Your Hands is a collaboration with Thomas Newson. We worked on stuff with Thomas before, but we never really got to release it. And after Savior, we wanted to make like a follow-up for Savior. And at the time, Thomas was with us in the studio, and he had like really good ideas for melodies and that kind of stuff. So basically, we used kind of the same sounds. We used that Savior, but we also used some of like Thomas's like signature songs, and we had a lot of input in the track, and that's how the track came about. Yeah, it just came off Future Music in Australia. I mean, like, there's a lot of really cool festivals. Like Tomorrowland, Tomorrow World is one of the best festivals in the world. EDC, like last summer we closed EDC Vegas, which was for us one of the biggest shows we've ever played. But Future Music is also like a really cool festival. It's very, like, it's a huge lineup, and it has like a variety of live acts and huge DJs that play the festival. And I think what's specifically fun about Future is that the whole festival, the whole lineup basically travels from city to city, and you're gonna be together with all these DJs and artists for at least 2 weeks. So you actually like get to know each other, like you get to know certain artists, you get to hang out, you get to party together. And that is totally different from usual. Like, usually you go from show to show, you go by yourself or with management or with friends, but you never really get to meet the other artists. It's always like, hey, and it's fun for like a few hours. But now I always say it like, it's like a school trip, you know, like, but for DJs. And it's a lot of fun. It's like, you know, like, boys will be boys, like, just hang out and party, and it's really cool to meet the people on another level, you know, like, you like, actually, like, last year, like, not this year, but the year before, Future, yeah, we really got to meet, like, Dyro, Danik, Hardwell, and we actually became, like, really good friends because of that festival. So, Future, in terms of, like, bonding and getting to know other artists, it's one of the most fun festivals. The first time was 808 Festival. It was like a big venue, and last time we played a demo, if I'm correct, and it was a really good show. And it was not that long ago, it was in October, and I was actually really excited when I saw Bangkok again in the schedule. I'm like, yeah, that was fun last time, so always happy to be back here. So yeah, usually you, like, when you're touring, you don't have a lot of time to actually do stuff. Like, that's what people always think, like, oh, it's so good that you see all these cities and countries, but like, I would love to go to one of the beautiful beaches in Thailand, but I never have the time to actually go. But so yeah, with the amount of time we usually have, I'm a big foodie, so I just like to eat local food, and that's what I did tonight, and it was really good. I know, like, as bass jackers, I know Ralph listens to a lot of like rock, indie rock kind of music. We both really love the band Phoenix. I listen to a lot of hip hop. Also, like, the, you know, like the more commercial. You know, I like the sing along kind of stuff. You know, like the Coco and that kind of, like, it has like a party vibe and it amps me up. If I would go out to a club, I would listen to hip hop before I go out. Actually, I think we have a lot of those tunes, which is actually really bad. But, you know, like, whenever we go to Ibiza, we always kind of like play Benga Boys Ibiza because it's just funny, you know. For Christmas, there's a bunch of like stupid songs that you just listen because it's Christmas, you know, like Mariah Carey and that kind of stuff. And, like, it's really funny, but when, like, I know Ralph, my partner, from Bass Jackers for a long time now, and when we were like younger, we used to like take his dad's car and drive around, and we used to play like Backstreet Boys, like, windows open, and like don't give a f-. If that's not guilty pleasure, I don't know what guilty pleasure is. Oh wow, that's a really difficult question, because like I personally live kind of like day to day and like enjoy the moment, but 10 years is a long time. I think I still would want to be playing shows, just not as much as right now, because now the touring schedule is just really crazy. You know, like in 10 years I might like have a family, maybe some kids, you know, same for Ralph. But yeah, still working in the music industry for sure, still producing music, hope still playing shows, just a little less, you know? Dear fans, thank you so much for like supporting our music, listening to our music, and coming to the shows, showing love on social media. And, like, we see all those messages. We try to answer like as many of us, many as possible. And yeah, just a huge thank you. Thanks. Rad Radio. Rad Radio.